I'm Milindu from Sri Lanka, and I'm a contributor of Scholab, which is a popular organization among Google Summer of Code.
Sorry, Steve is doing the
PM. Okay. Awesome. So, I'm a contributor in Scholab, which is a popular organization in among the Google Summer of Code students and Google Coding students, and also a contributor in Libels Lab, which is a very young organization, like few months old for now. And at Libels Lab, we have been working on several projects, like small tools which will be help the people who are basically working on dev and ops sites. So this tool which I am going to share with you today is something we started few months back actually. So before going into the tool, I'll tell the problem that we are trying to solve. Okay, so most of you have used at least one task runner tool in your life, right? Maybe Grunt, maybe Gulp, maybe Ant, maybe Makefiles. So I'll take Grunt as example. With Grunt, you can run any kind of JavaScript-based task, but the problem is when it comes to binaries, we have problems, right? So either we have to install these binaries on our machines. Like sometimes they are not very straightforward, and once the project is done, maybe we are not needing these tools again. So, but we sometimes forget to uninstall this stuff, or maybe because we did a lot of stuff to install this stuff, we sometimes find it hard to find a way to uninstall this stuff totally. So when the next problem is when I share my code with someone else, what happens is they have to do the same thing again, right? They have to go through all the problems again. And the thing is, when it comes to continuous integration, like building your tools on Jenkins, I have to install my all these tools, all these binaries on Jenkins instance also, which I don't like, because like on my machine I can like simply format my machine and remove stuff, but on Jenkins it's very hard. So my approach for this is, what I usually do is I use Docker for this one, and Docker really does a really nice job with this. So I usually have several scripts to run Docker containers as my binary tools. These are like very simplified stripe.dot versions of my actual code. So you can see I'm actually using a Bower to Bower container to do Bower install, and then Composer to do a Composer install, and then PHP container to do RTC and key generate. This is like initializing the project. And when you come to the deployment script, you can see like there are a lot of environment variables we have to pass, and a lot of like maybe we need to pass mount a lot of volumes there. So the things also get a bit complicated with strips also. So what we thought, actually, can't we have a small tool which will do all this stuff, and we only have to define all this stuff in a one small YAML file, YAML configuration. That is what actually dunner do, right? So this is a simple dunner configuration file. You can see I have defined two tasks here. One is build and one is deploy. And in my build task, I have three steps. One is to Bower install. The next step is to Composer install. And the third one is to PHP artisan key generate. And you can see in my build task, I am using three separate containers, three separate images, Docker images. And you can see in my second task, I'm using AWS CLI to deploy my application into Elastic Beanstalk, and I am passing environment variables very easily. And what I have to do is, at the end, say dunner do build to run the build task here, or say dunner do deploy to run the deployment task. And this is a bit of a complex example. So you can see here, I have removed the Composer install to separate task. which I can say dunner do compose, because I need to run compose install several times when I add a new dependency to composer. So I removed it into a separate task. And you can see in the build step, I have said in the second step, name at compose, which means every task in compose task, every step in compose task will be imported to that task there. So when I say dunner do build, it will first bubble install, and then composer install, and then do the PHP artisan. And let's come to the compose one. You can see here, I am mounting my volumes, right? So you can mount any number of volumes to your task, like this, with YAML arrays. And when it comes to deploy, you can see I am passing environment variables here. And if you look at the environment variables, you can see the last one, AWS default region, is a simple one. I am simply telling the US East one. But the first two, access key, I'm not hard coding my actual access key on my dunner configuration, because I'm going to put this stuff into my GitHub account. So I don't want to these secret keys to be in my source code. Right, so what actually happens is I'm telling dunner to get this AWS key from actual host machine's environment variables. So the good thing is you can have .env files. You can define these AWS keys and AWS secret on your .env file, and dunner will pick this from .env. Or if it's not there, it will pick from the host environment. And here, you can see, like, I am passing a parameter. I am saying dunner do deploy production. And in the deploy task, you can see actually the last string is $1. What happens is actually when I say production, when I say do deploy production, Elastic Beanstalk update application dash dash application name will, the next one will be production. So with this way, we can pass parameters to our command. So we can customize things in our command with runtime argument passing. And here you can see, I am mounting several folders to my container. And the second one, you can see I'm saying WR, which means it is a read-write mount. So for folders like logs, you have to have a way to get your logs into your host machine. So I'm mounting my logs as a writable folder. And the second one I'm just mounting as a read folder. So no one can, in your container, change your SSH keys. The default is read only, so you don't have to worry about putting R, just R, if you want it to be just read only. And this cool thing is, like, with build, you saw we have three separate containers using, right? So thing is, like, usually what we do is we pull one container and run the task, and pull the second container and run the second task. But with async, what we do is we first go through all the steps and get all the images pulled from Docker Hub or maybe whatever the repository you have. And this will happen parallel. So which means that if you have 10 containers in one task, all the 10 containers will be pulled from Docker Hub at once, which makes sort of time, which saves sort of time. And then we will start running our steps one by one, sequentially. And the good thing is, we today morning released the version 1. Actually, like, this is a very young project up today. Like, we have only worked on this 3 months and just several developers. So if you are interested in dunner, using dunner, you can install it with snap install dunner, which will give you a working binary of dunner tool. And actually, we are planning to have apt-get with private PPAs. But actually, we were working on that, but we couldn't get it done with the time. So hopefully, before the conference ends, we'll be having APT support also, and also Brew. Brew is also on the way. So anyone using Mac, you'll be able to use dunner on your Mac machines. Yes, so this is why actually we are here. Actually, this dunner tool is a very new tool, so we need feedback from you people, because you are the open source contributors, and we need a lot of people contributing to us, and we need a lot of feedback from you people, and your expertise, maybe you have better ideas for us, you have better suggestions, or maybe you know some similar tools which do the same thing, or maybe you know the better ones. So come to us, you can talk to us, you can give us feedback, how you can define how we should be going forward with our development. So feel free to go to this URL and give us some feedback. So we know like what should be the features that we should be implementing in the future. And also, dunner is just a code name. It's not an actual name. So we need your ideas on a cool name for this dunner. Dunner just means Docker runner. So come to this our GitHub issue, so you can contribute, you can start contributing from there. So you can give us suggestions, and we can have discussions over there. So maybe once we are finalized with names, we can have logos, and maybe we can ship you some swags, maybe some t-shirts and stickers with dunner, whatever the name we come finalized with. So please help us with this small project, which is very young at the moment. So I hope you will be like, you'll try this one and give us some feedback today. And that's it, actually. So you can go to dunner repository. It's on GitHub, lepers.lab dunner. So go there, and if you if you like, you can contribute to us. If you are expecting to participate in GSOC, we actually under Scholab, so Scholab will be having slots for Leopard's Lab, maybe for dunner also. So if you are expecting to participate in GSOC this year, maybe you can come contribute to dunner. Maybe you will get a slot there. And you can find me at Agent Milindu. so maybe in GitHub, maybe in Twitter. And we have time, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah, one time.
So, oh, cool. One small thing. This is also a kind of a pet project. So, install the tool. Like we do, like curl http get docker.com/bash. So, this is a small script which installs Docker on your machine. In the same way, we are planning to have dunner on installer 2. So, you can curl https installer 2/dunner. Pipe to bash. It will install dunner on your machine, whether it's apt, whether it's brew, whether it's yum, whatever. We will be have a small installer script uploaded there. This is a like kind of a pet project of Leopard's Lab. If you have in your tools, if you want to publish your tools with us, you can come to installer 2 in our Leopard's Lab, and you can create a PR for small scripts, so you will be able to install your tool, like installer curl installer 2/ whatever your name. So just that from me. Yeah, I'm done.
Questions? Thanks, here we are. No? Wow. Covered the subject so completely that there is nothing left to ask. Seriously not? Nope. Going once, going twice, three times. All right, in that case, thank you very much.